When you drive a Mercedes, you don't care.
I see it.
Now, what you say about your girl?
Ah,
yeah, that's my
fair. Is that your beep?
Every song, they be talking about fuck, taking my girl, having a party on, taking a jizz and a jaw and everything.
Damn, just, we jizz and jaws?
Everything.
Dang.
Every song nowadays is always my girl. Like, why can't you get your own girl?
So they ain't fucking their own girl. They fucking somebody else's girl.
Yeah, they always.
What do you think they doing to their own girl? They ain't jizzing in their jaws?
They obviously ain't got no time for us. They got mine.
You know, because I was watching that Wu-Tang situation yesterday, and old girl RZA's the beat maker, right?
Mm-hmm.
His girl left him because she didn't have no time for her.
He didn't have no time for her.
Yeah.
He was always downstairs.
Making beats.
Mm-hmm.
Or jizzing in somebody else's girl's jaw.
Yeah.
Dang. So they neglecting their girls, leaving them sleeping. Damn, they be at home lonely. Meanwhile, they dudes is out there jizzing in somebody else's jaw.
Yep.
He in here listening to UGK?
Yeah.
UGK front, back, side to side.
You should take my girl home and have a party on her pussy.
Yeah, he said he gonna take the girl home and have a party on her vagina.
Not the girl, my girl.
Oh, his girl.
Your girl. Like,
yeah.
They saying, like, they when they talking to you, they mean my girl. They talking about my girl.
Yeah, they gonna take somebody's girl and have a party on her vagina. Why everybody got in that? And then we wonder why everybody out here stealing bras. Because it's the cool thing to do.
They tell you to do it in every song.
Because Pimp C and Bum B out here.
Man, that was early, too.
Yeah, so they've been having party on pussy. Now.
This is the 90s, the early
90s. This ain't no 2003, 23 stuff. This is some early 90s.
They've been trampling pussy since the 90s.
They've been trampling pussy.
Yeah.
Trampling pussy. Ain't that something?
Damn. You ain't never trampled a pussy.
Why would I be trampling pussy? You trampled a pussy is the question. Well, damn. Have you trampled my pussy?
Yeah, remember the time you told me stop?
He had me hunched over. He had me by the shoulders and was pulling me down. And I was just like, what the fuck are you doing? But that was some crazy. He was like, yeah, I lost myself real quick. It felt 18 again or something. It was crazy.
Y'all, I had to apologize. I was trampling.
Yeah, he called me the next day and apologized.
I'm sorry, man.
This nigga here looking at the woman's booty after drive through. Don't be looking at her booty. You ain't nothing.
Baby, you ain't nothing.
Watch your age of a king magazine, but you gon' get yourself hurt, yeah. Hey, baby, I brought you in the back just to have a conversation. Really think you need some ventilation. Let's talk about you and me. Oh, I can't believe it. Ooh, ooh, she out on me.
All right, y'all, let's talk silent households. What's good, y'all? Monty Appleton. If you have a couple of minutes, I have a couple of messages. Yesterday, Dre and I went to go grab something to eat, and there was a family sitting at a table adjacent to us. This is not coming from a judgmental space. This is coming from an observation space so that we have a frame of reference to the points I'm about to make. Of the three people sitting at the table, there was a father, a mother, and a son. The son was 5 at most. Very vocal. But all the words that came out of the son's mouth was, gimme mine, I want. And you may have said, God damn it. The most talkative person at the table was the child. And of the things he said, they were, give me mine, I want. The mother, she may have spoke 5 words while she was sitting there. And the father said nothing. So the entire duration of their meal, there were maybe a multitude of 20 words spoken between everybody at the table. I can't remember who it was that said, it might have been Tony Robbins, where he said, we say what, the same 70,000 words? I don't know, that may be an exaggeration, but we say the same words in a day's time over and over again. Our vocabulary is only expansive as our vocabulary that we expanded. If we stopped learning new words, we're going to say the same stuff over and over and over again. A silent household is pretty self-explanatory. Nobody's talking unless somebody's yelling at somebody or giving direction. No conversations are being had. My formative years, I grew up in silent households, and then when I got to my teen years, I moved into a house where people actually speak to each other. But back to the dinner table. Dad didn't say one word the entire meal, and whenever the son addressed the father, the mom answered for him. Pay attention to that. And then when the mom talked to the child, it was like really one or two words, like, you think so? Or, okay. It was really not engaging conversation. Pay attention to that. And then we already know how the kid talks. What's detrimental about a silent household is, one, everybody doesn't come from a silent household. So when two people come together and one doesn't know how to have a conversation because no one ever held a conversation with them, we think about guys who only know how to talk about sports, cars, and sex. No one ever taught them how to talk about anything else because in their home, they didn't talk about anything. And when they did talk to people, they were talking to other boys who wanted to talk about sports, cars, and sex. When I went from my silent households into my talkative households, I didn't understand how to function. I thought it was really dumb. I was like, why are you guys always talking all the damn time? Shut up. But I was only used to being spoken to when I was being yelled at. So you have to understand, when someone comes from one environment to another, it's very uncomfortable for them. So if you come from a talkative background and you marry someone who does not come from a talkative background, you guys are gonna bump up against each other. And usually the talkative person is gonna look at the person who doesn't talk and be like, how come you don't know how to talk? Meanwhile, the silent person is like, why don't you shut up? Let's go for part two. All right, y'all, let's continue the conversation about silent households. What's good, y'all? I'm Lonnie Appleton. If you have a couple of minutes, I have a couple of messages. This is part two of the silent household conversation. You have to understand, the first man or woman your child is going to speak to is you. So if you're having engaging in conversations with your child, then when they grow up to become adults and teens, they're not going to know how to have engaging conversations, period. But they're definitely not going to know how to have engaging conversations with the opposite sex. I know there's more than one woman who has ran across a guy who, instead of admitting that he feels uncomfortable with having a conversation, tries to make her feel stupid for trying to talk to him. Why are you trying to talk about that? Man, you doing too much. Can we just sit and chill? And then, of course, to push the head down. Oh, that was so inappropriate, wasn't it? But that's what happens when you're with a guy. He doesn't want to talk. He just wants to fill your mouth up. I might delete that. That's why when you see me talking to any of my children, but definitely my sons, I am making sure that I am gauging them. I'm teaching them how to think. I'm teaching them how to use their brain, how to have ideas, how to express their ideas, and for them to feel that their ideas are valued. I'm doing that not only for them, but for their future spouses, so that when their future spouses try to sit down and have conversations with them, they're not one of those guys that shut down because they feel uncomfortable. Most men, when they feel uncomfortable, they get defensive and they shut down instead of admitting, I'm uncomfortable. This is a skill that I don't have. See, if men stop shutting down, and women, but I've dealt with men in relation to this topic. Most men will sooner get abrasive and shut down and get defensive instead of saying, this is a deficiency for me and I need to fix it. And it's an easy fix. All you have to do is start having conversations outside of the conversational topics that you're used to. The mom answered all the questions for the dad at the dinner table. Mom has already observed that the dad doesn't speak, so she became a crutch for him. When me and Dre first got together, he never spoke. If you watched one of our videos where I was talking about how we came together, one of my fears was, we're not gonna ever have anything to talk about because we don't really talk now. I'm a don't speak unless I have something valuable to say. But I grew up in a silent household, so I never spoke unless spoken to or if I had something to say. Dre likes to have random conversations, and I don't see the value in that. And we bumped up against each other for a very long time because he wants to just ramble about random stuff. And I'm just looking at him like, come back when you actually got something to say to me. But both spaces are valuable. But if the man's not speaking, you can't be a crutch for him. The man has to be okay with being prompted to speak, and the woman has to be okay with prompting him to speak.